This is the differential stain, the Gram stain process. Differential stains are unique from simple stains in that they use at least two dyes, two different stains, and you're trying to distinguish between different cell structures. So you're going to start by getting your slide that has your specimen already affixed to it. And you're going to start with the first dye. Now, it helps to line up the order in which you're going to proceed, just so that you're not struggling during the timing steps trying to look and locate the bottle that you need. So I'm going to flood this, much like we do in the simple stain. Now, normally you would have a clothespin if you're holding this. I'm just going to lay this flat. I'm just trying to show you here for the video. And I'm going to wait 30 seconds. I want to have my water ready so that when that 30 seconds is up, then I can be ready to rinse right away. Okay, so it's been the 30 seconds. I'm going to rinse for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And at this point, the crystal violet is in all the cells, whether they're Gram positive or Gram negative. So now I'm going to go on to the next step, which is add the mordant. And in this mordant is called Gram's iodine. And again, I'm going to flood the slide. And I'm going to leave it for 30 seconds. Now, the reason why we have this step here of the mordant is that the crystal violet molecule is very small and it goes easily into the cell, but it could also easily wash out of the cell. So by adding the iodine, I'm adding another very small molecule into the cell, and when the two go into the cell, they unite, they combine and bond together, and they get trapped inside of the cell, so they don't very easily wash out. Okay, so it's been 30 seconds. I'm going to now go back and do my 5-second rinse, just like I did before. And now I'm going to move on to the decolorizer step, which we'll talk about more in just a second. This has to be a very, very quick step. As soon as you start decolorizing, you need to rinse it off. And again, you would leave your slide flat on the rack. I'm just tilting it so you can see. I'm going to immediately have that rinsed. I have to be quick here. I'm going to end up stripping all of the stain out, which I don't want to do. And then finally, I'm going to go in and add my counter stain, or what's called a secondary stain, and that is safranet. So what happens here, if you were to have a slide with specimen that had all Gram negative cells and you only added this first sequence here, the Gram, the crystal violet and the Gram's iodine, it would end up washing out at the decolorizing step and you would be left with clear cells, so you don't want to do that. So we follow up with the last step, anticipating it could possibly be Gram negative or a mixed sample, with the safranet, so that if you were to wash out the stain because it's Gram negative during the decolorizing step, you then would have the safranet, which would be your last step, and that would add some pigment to the cell, even if it were Gram negative. So remember that in the Gram stain, the slides that have the specimen on here, the Gram positive cell is going to end up, I'm going to go ahead and rinse here because I'm at my 30 seconds. The Gram-positive cell is going to take in the peptidoglycan and it'll get trapped inside that thick peptidoglycan layer. The Gram-negative cell does take in the crystal violet stain initially, but when you go through that decolorizing step, it basically degrades and breaks down that Gram-negative wall, and the crystal violet will wash right back out. So you need to do that last step with the safranet to pick up the Gram-negative. And that is the Gram stain.